Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Probably one of the most important concepts of any programming language is the variable. Typically the first feature that is taught on any programming language. Here we're going to try and provide you an explanation as to what a variable is. There are some general approaches to try and help you understand what a variable is initially. Typically, you're presented with the concept that the variable is a container for storing values, for data. Or else sometimes the variable is described as a symbolic name, which is a reference to an object holding the value that we want to store. Or thirdly, sometimes the variable can be described in a more direct way. It is simply a reserved memory location to store values. Unlike when teaching a group of students face to face, you have probably prior knowledge of their capabilities and understanding. When teaching online, it's difficult to know exactly where to start. So let's see if we can find some common ground. We can probably all relate to the idea of applications. Here we have the Mac operating system. It will be similar if you're running Windows. You might open up the Task Manager, for example. In the Task Manager, or here the Activity Monitor in macOS, we can see all the applications that are currently running. In addition to that, we can see how much CPU that is currently being utilized by each application. And in addition to that, we can also see how much memory is being utilized. It is this memory component, this RAM component, that we want to focus in on. I think we can be fairly confident and say that every single application that is running requires a certain amount of memory. So we just need to ask ourselves, why is this the case? Well, in general terms, when the application is running, when we start an application, we need to store data, maybe about that application, maybe information about how to present that application on the screen, and so on. So depending on how much data we're storing, depending on the application, how it's been built, will depend on, for example, how much data, how much memory is being stored. Now, take, for example, here we have Safari. You might just be able to see this. Safari is using 576 megabytes of memory on this machine. I think it has a few tabs open. The more tabs that I open, the more memory it utilizes. So just to summarize, or just to be brief here, every single tab I open up in Safari, that tab and the data within that tab potentially is going to be stored in memory. RAM, or memory, is utilized by applications to store data temporarily. So it just happens that RAM, or memory, is very fast to access. The CPU can quickly access the data in memory and then process it. And this is partly the reason why we utilize memory, because we can quickly access the data. If we would compare memory or RAM in our computer to, for example, the hard drive of some description, the hard drive, we could use the hard drive to store data, of course, but it's not as quick at accessing and processing the data from the hard drive than it is from accessing and processing data from memory. So let's just visualize this very briefly. So here's our Django application, for example. Now, when we run our Django application, the likelihood is that we will have data and values that we want to store temporarily so that we can access them later, for example. Let's take, for example, a situation within our Django application whereby we want to store data about, for example, an input. So let's imagine that our user here has sent via a web form data to our application. So when the data is retrieved by Django, that data needs to be stored somewhere. So the data sent by the user, maybe they've typed in their personal details into a form on a web page, that will be sent to the Django application. Now we need some way of managing that data, storing that data. So typically that data will get stored into RAM or memory. So the idea is that we store that data, information about the user, into memory so that when Django needs to process that information, it can quickly grab that information back and process that data. Maybe it needs to kind of store it into, for example, a database. Into a database. There we go. So we can see potentially now that RAM is really important, a really important tool for our application to store data temporarily. Now, although this is a very simple example, there are many reasons why we might want to store values or data in RAM that we can then process later within our application. So that leads us to the question, how do we actually store data in RAM or memory in our computer, and how do we retrieve it back into our application? The exacts of how this is performed is abstracted away from us in the Python programming language, and we don't necessarily need to know this in any real detail. All we really need to know in a high level is how to actually reference and store data, or tell Python to store data in memory, and then also we need to learn how to get that data back. So this is where the variable comes into play. So what we can do here is we can build a variable. So let's give this variable a name. So I'm just going to call this variable name, referencing to the username. So actually, let's just call this username. So this is my variable here that I've set up in my program. Okay. Now, whenever the user types in something into the form, that goes in my app, and then the username gets extracted from that data the user's typed in and sent, and then it gets stored in RAM. Now, what we do when we store that data into RAM, we need to reference it. We need a way of retrieving that data back. So when the data is stored, we make a reference name. In this case, we're going to call it username. In addition to that, we also then specify what data we want to store. So let's pretend the user's typed in a name. So we then reference that name. So what we've done here is we provided Python an instruction. We've told Python to create a new variable, create a new data space or storage in RAM, and we want to store the value. This is on the right-hand side. We want to store this value, this name. So now what's happened is Python's taken over, and it's now stored this name, Xander, in RAM, with this name being a reference point to collect and return this data from RAM. So let's go back to our concepts here. Containers for storing data values. Okay, so a variable is a container. So it's described as a container. So what's happening here then is that when we create a variable, it means that somewhere on RAM, a space in RAM is being created. Somewhere in RAM, some space is being created, and inside of this space is going to be our value. In this case, it's just the name that we've created. I spell that correctly. Okay. So next, the symbolic name reference to an object. So a variable here has been described as a symbolic name or reference to an object. The concept of objects, we're not necessarily going to cover it on this course, but everything in Python can be considered an object. So here, for example, in RAM, we are storing this name, which is a string, which is an object. So that's what it refers to as an object here. So the symbolic name. So here we have the symbolic name, which is the name we provided in order to tell our application, or in order to provide our application a way of extracting the information back from RAM. So anytime I need to add, remove, change, or return Xander, which is stored in RAM here, this string, I basically need to reference this symbolic name here, username. So that's what the username is referring to here. This variable name is considered this a symbolic name that's utilized to access the data in RAM, or in our container, if you like, that's being stored in RAM. So the third example, reserved memory location to store values. So here we have the idea that this data here that's stored in RAM or memory, this word Xander, is being stored in a very specific place. Now behind the scenes, obviously this is a location in the RAM. Now obviously just this name here isn't enough to grab the data from RAM. Behind the scenes, there is a memory location. This name is then behind the scenes connected to a memory location, so we can actually access that data back in a specific part of the RAM. Because remember, we saw earlier, lots of programs might be running, lots of programs are using RAM. So we need to know what part of RAM each program is using. But as it suggests, it's a reserved memory location. So we reserve space to store our variable, and in our variable we have values, whether it be strings or integers, numbers or floating points and so on. So hopefully we can utilize this now as a starting point to now start to build Python variables. So let's move into the next tutorial where we go ahead and create some variables and assign some values.